she is dead. Nothing on earth can change that. But the day I lost my daughter Sarah to the fire, I had already lost my wife. I believe. When the angels return to Earth, they'll do so with fire. For our homes still burn when we receive the invitation. A house for lease. With 3 days' journey.
The house is full. You can add anything you like to it, but please do not take anything with you.
We do not have anything.
All you may need has most likely been left behind in the house.
Have you worked for the Wakefields very long, Mr. Hendricks?
Isaac.
Isaac.
Yeah. Well, it's always difficult finding the right people. And I can tell that you're different. You're good folk. The great expanse of land that you saw on the way here, you can use it as a shortcut back to town. It'll be about 25 minutes. Walking, that is.
I can only pay you for 2 months up front.
No, no, no. 1 month is fine. There you are. It's all done then. Ladies.
Well?
What first? I think a bedroom. I need to lie down.
Thank you.
There may be some flour, but I would be surprised if there's much of anything else.
I'm really not very hungry. And I don't think that Charlotte will want to eat.
Well, if Charlotte's not hungry and you're not hungry and I'm not hungry, I suppose there's no need to make dinner tonight then. Tell me, how long did that man say it had been since the last people lived here?
He didn't. Why?
I find it strange that the house is covered in dust, but the plants are well watered.
I hated myself for my silence. I hated them for theirs. What else could we do?
How long do you think you'll stay now?
A little girl was dead.
You don't need to stay because of me,
Charlotte.
And you don't need to stay here for John either.
Listen. I've been waiting to give you this. I found it in a pocket day after.
So strange that it could be so close and I can suddenly feel nothing. I'm going to do a thorough cleaning today to see what we've gotten ourselves into.
Fine. I'll go into town and see what they have for work.
Do you mean patients?
Patients, labor, whatever I can get.
But it's not even been a week.
How long should I wait?
But you're a professional, John. You shouldn't take just any job.
And we shouldn't have kept our money in the house. You didn't want to put it in a bank, so I'll take whatever I can get for now. Besides, what little Jack loaned us is not going to last us very long.
As long as you're going into town, then there is a list of things that we need.
Existed as if in a dream, from which we could not awake.
Thank you.
I could not help but feel that something had followed us. Or found us.
For the new doctor.
Yes. Waylon. John Waylon.
We always had a problem with rats in this town. And how do you find the house?
It's fine. Thank you.
And your wife?
My wife?
Well, your wife and her sister, too. Are they doing fine?
Yes, they are. We're all getting along just fine, thank you.
Perhaps they would like to come into town. We have a women's club there.
I'll mention it to them.
Please.
Forgive me, but I must be getting on now. Good day to you.
Good day.
Jenny just come through here?
No. There are trunks full of old clothing in here. Maybe there are some things we can use. So much of it's rotted to dust. It's a shame.
You shouldn't be exerting yourself.
It'll have to be altered. It'll all have to be altered.
No. Are you all right?
Yes.
What happened?
They're rats, all right.
I knew I heard something last night.
Well, I'll set out the traps then. They carry disease. We don't want them getting into the house.
Look at this.
Me?
Yes. You studied French?
Ages ago.
I found it tucked away in the library. I thought you might know what it says.
Ugh. It's a lease from 1785, I think.
The date I can make out myself.
John, a small furnished house in Toulouse. The rest is just legal. To tell you the truth, it's rather hard to read. In fact, it looks like the second half is written in Dutch.
Well, I suppose we can make do with these.
I wish that we could forge enough material in that house to make something more modern.
We did find a coat for you, but it's a bit worn.
This is precisely the kind of dress that Mother would have worn every day of her life. What would she have done with it?
Turned it inside out and used it as two dresses.
Sarah!
I think we should go inside now.
There's someone in the house.
What is it?
Lock the door.
What's happening?
Perhaps he was a previous tenant, and he came back for something. Left something behind.
His manner was cold. It did not look like he was looking for anything at all.
This could be my fault. I should have thought to lock up the house.
We've never kept the doors locked before. Why should we start now?
We don't know anyone here. Jenny's right. We should keep the doors locked.
Oh, no.
What is it?
By all accounts, a flock of chickens.
My dears, welcome.
Absolutely.
you tell me that you actually did or didn't have a dressmaker?
And Mr. Jamil confessed that one of his dogs had gotten hold of his wife's prized pheasant and run off.
Really? I've always wanted to come. My husband, Peter, would never allow it.
The two of you don't even seem like sisters.
Ladies, please excuse me.
Excuse me for a moment.
These are the very type of women I've spent my life attempting to separate myself from. They do not have a clue of what is going on in the world right now.
Maybe they don't wish to know.
They choose not to know. They live in a time capsule.
They live in it. But we look it. Perhaps we'll start a trend.
Ah, no!
Shh. They're going to hear us.
I care not. Charlotte. I've been thinking. I want to go back east. I feel that you and John need to be alone right now. You are going to be just fine. I don't think that you need me here anymore.
I can't survive what's happened alone.
You're not alone, Charlotte.
Aren't I?
Charlotte, I've reached an age where I've become a woman of no means or position. And the chances of my marrying now are slim. No amount of education can change that. When Sarah was alive, it was easy to forget these things. I traded my security for knowledge, and those qualities are not exactly considered desirable in a woman. Now, when I see you and John together, it only reminds me of what I will not have in my life.
What do you know of John and me?
John is a good man for you. You have to let him be a good man for you.
You love him? Yes. What are you saying? I can remember it in my mind, but not my heart. Please, Jennifer, I need you to stay here with me. With us. Please.
Where were you last night? I woke up and you were gone.
I couldn't sleep.
Strange.
strange that you didn't wake me.
I couldn't sleep. I went into one of the spare rooms to write.
The attic?
Yes.
To write.
I just told you that.
You blame me for what happened?
There's someone on the roof. The roof! There's something on the roof!
Could be the man from last night.
It's nothing. It's the rats.
What I heard was not a rat.
You're overreacting.
I do not overreact, John.
Yes,
Jenny,
you do.
Please, what? Be quiet.
Big rat.
Fog is heavy. It's hard to see.
John? Where's the rifle?
Did you see anyone?
Such an unusual mist. So unusual.
What's the matter? Are you all right?
Of course I am. Jack, you know you can stay the night. We have plenty of room.
Thank you, but I have to be off again this evening. I was simply passing near enough to make a stop, see how you were doing.
I'm glad you did.
You know, John, you do not look well.
How do you mean?
You have all had a great deal of misfortune. Is there anything that I can do?
No, Jack, you've done enough.
John. I may have been your professor 10 years ago, but I've been your friend for almost as long. Tell me what is on your mind.
We were together. Behind the house when the fire broke out. And Jenny was gone. It was early evening. When we got back, everything was in flames. I
ran through the door. Ran upstairs. My baby was on fire. I couldn't reach her. I swear to God, Jack. I couldn't reach her.
I'm sorry, son.
I have known Charlotte ever since we were children. And there wasn't a moment in my life that I did not know I would spend the rest of my life with her. She was so filled with life. And now everything that I thought I knew, I do not understand. And I do not understand her.
Yes, you do.
How is your mother?
Half a year past 90. No end in sight. And you are well, Charlotte?
Yes. Fine, thank you.
You know, it's not too late to have another baby.
Jack.
Never underestimate a woman's need to have a child, John. It overrides all other priorities. It makes her spirit whole. After all, my dear, what else does a woman have if not the joy of creation?
Thank you.
saw.
How?
Does there need to be a reason?
I heard a voice. A child's voice. Now, you said you saw a girl.
What?
Last night, John thought he saw the figure of a little girl.
John?
We need to leave here as soon as possible.
Where do you suggest we go?
Anywhere. Back east. Stay with your father.
You know that's not an option for me.
Staying here could be dangerous.
We don't know that.
What do we do? What do we do?
I'll go into town, see Mr. Hendricks, see if there's something else, another house.
I don't trust Mr. Hendricks.
Why?
It's just all too strange. This house? The way he inquired about us after the fire? This place is filled with other people's belongings. I mean, truly, how would he even know about us?
By virtue of his vocation, I would guess.
That far away. And now this?
All right, enough. The two of you begin writing inquiries for another house. I will deal with Mr. Hendricks. We are educated, civilized people. We cannot let this get the better of us. Give in to fear and panic. We will go on as normal. Behave as though nothing has happened. I told Jenny to lock her door. Call out if anything at all should happen.
John? Has it occurred to you that Sarah's here? With us?
Yes. You weren't expecting that answer?
I'm not leaving here. Sarah is here. By some grace of God or outside of God, I don't care. She's here in this house, and I'm not going to leave her again.
Sarah is dead. Nothing that happens here is going to change that.
That's the doctor talking, not my husband.
Facts, Charlotte, are not a matter of emotion or intelligence. They're simply facts.
For the first time, I feel hope here. We can't leave until we at least try to understand this. Opportunity for us both.
Thank you. doing?
What do you mean?
He left in the middle of the night.
What?
Yes. You said the room was too hot. You seen Jenny? I can't find her. She's not in her room.
Dreamed it.
Have you been out here all night? John, don't. Do such a thing.
I don't know.
And to leave them buried here when there's a cemetery so close by.
What do you mean?
About half an acre south of the house, there's a cemetery. Come.
No.
We're gonna go inside.
A vague memory of something long and dark with red eyes. Much like the sunset. And I seem to be sinking into deep green water. And there was a singing. In my ears, like the voice of the sea, inviting me to wander. Oh, I'm so tired.
Of course you are. You've been up all night.
There's something wrong here, Charlotte.
Only misunderstood.
No, it's something terrible.
This is illegal. Not to mention stupid.
Not out here, sir.
Stupid? This coming from the man who just moved into the Wakefields? I would look hard first before casting stones, Doctor.
And I'd look hard before taunting a man who's pushing a needle into your arm.
Then you like the house, Dr. Whalen. Find it cozy, do you?
Quiet yourselves, you stupid fools.
With me. Oh, no. No, I meant to leave those here. I'll be back within a fortnight.
To me to do so.
What are we looking for?
Anything about the house. Anything about the people who lived here before us.
1962.
You're a writer?
The war?
Yes.
Long time ago.
Dear Brother Marshall, we are waiting for word of Jack and do not know what is happening in Pennsylvania.
In those weeks, I wondered, can life be born out of death? In the darkest of night, can people find their way home? Can they find each other? Story?
I've been inspired.
Sweetheart? We were happy. Probably more so than we deserved to be. I continued to search for answers. And Charlotte wrote a story. About a little room with yellow wallpaper. Thank you.
I like it. I think it's very, very good.
It's all right.
And who's behind the wallpaper? Is it you?
Maybe. It doesn't really matter.
This is Miss Sayer. Good morning.
Good morning.
John? John, this is Miss Sayer.
Hello.
Jenny's told me all about you. About both of you. Well, it doesn't like that we've returned.
You have the most interesting friends.
Catherine is a woman I trust. I've known of her since my years at school. She studies many things, things that would be considered to be beyond nature. I know that she can help.
Jenny, so much has happened since you've been gone. John and I are so much better.
And that runs counter to how you look. You're both pale and thin.
Excuse me, but she is simply wandering into the house.
Do you know when this house was built, Dr. Wayland?
1792.
You don't want me here, do you?
No. It's just a bit of a surprise, that's all.
I see. Do you believe there's a logical explanation for what is happening in this house?
Reasonable, if not logical.
Good. That's a fair start.
I just don't understand what you think that you can do here.
Jenny believes the two of you are in danger.
Jenny exaggerates.
Miss Sayre, how do you feel about a nice hot cup of tea?
That would be lovely, my dear.
John, would you please gather the bags from the carriage?
There's a woman behind this wall.
A woman?
A dead woman?
No.
Perhaps you're speaking of a story that I've been writing. It's there, on the desk.
No. This house is full. Here they cannot leave. They will not.
Sarah?
And others.
How long have you known Jenny?
Oh, my dear, let's see. Well, it's got to be around 15 years now.
Has it been that long? Oh, where does it go?
Prior to her letter, Jenny's never mentioned you. I'm so sorry. That sounded just terrible.
It's perfectly fine. I understand what you meant.
Well, you see, I'm everybody's little secret. People aren't so quickly inclined to mention the friend who prefers to spend her leisure time hunting around in dark old houses and carrying on a full conversation with the wall.
I knew nothing of this, you see, until much later. We first met during my studies. Catherine was giving a lecture at chapel on secular rights and the modern woman.
May I ask you a question?
Well, of course, my dear.
Can you help us speak with Sarah?
Charlotte.
Well, it would be wonderful if I could, but I have found in situations such as this, no help from the living can be given to speak to the dead. Only you can speak to those that you love.
Then why have you come?
John.
It's all right, Jenny. I'm here because Jenny asked me to come. And sometimes a fresh perspective is as useful as anything else.
I'm quite happy that you're here. Anything you can tell us would be greatly appreciated.
I know, my dear.
What?
Catherine?
Jenny, can you fetch me my shawl?
Oh, yes, of course.
Someone is under there.
Why do you say that?
Because it's calling to John. You need to go there.
No!
Alone.
He's been gone too long.
I don't like this. Why did you tell him he had to go alone? You said that you were here to help us. I thought that this had to do with Sarah. Where is he? Speak to me!
Thank you.
I knew it if we stayed. I knew it in my heart.
No, no. Oh.
Mommy?
Oh. Oh, God.
Sweetheart. Am I dreaming?
Did you see us here? Have you heard us calling to you, my angel?
How? Where have you been?
In the fire.
No, honey. No, no. Not anymore.
Not that fire, Mommy.
Darling, no. There was no other fire.
Yes, there is.
Have you been in this house? Sarah, look at me. Where have you been?
In hell.
You don't mean that.
I've been burning in hell.
Liar. Liar.
Hell. You'll both burn in hell for what you're going.
Charlotte, look at me.
Why are they doing this to us?
You did this. It was you. You wanted me that night outside. You wanted it to be just us, our filthy lust.
Charlotte,
you don't really love me.
Stop this.
You've seen her. You've all seen her. She's with that man in this house. I have to find her. I have to go upstairs. Yes. You pulled her from this house.
Charlotte.
Let me go.
No, no.
Let me go.
Jenny, get my back. Us. It was not Sarah. They want us to believe that Sarah is here.
Sarah is here. She has been with you since the moment you lost her. She's even been in this house.
Quiet!
But John is right. John is right. That was not your daughter.
Jenny.
I can feel her, John. I can feel her. She's so close.
It's done. It's done now.
I wish that I could sleep my life away.
You know to go under the house.
It sounds like singing. When I hear it, I follow. But I never know what I'll find. The rest I rely on instinct.
Are we safe in here?
Yes. We're safe.
We leave in the morning. Charlotte, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, John. What's happening? Is she all right?
She's fine. Are you all right?
I'm fine, yes. I just couldn't stop sleeping. Where's Catherine? Charlotte? Charlotte, honey, is there anything that I can get for you? No, thank you. I have the most terrible dreams. It's 1:30 in the afternoon, and I can't seem to find Catherine.
Perhaps she's gone into town.
No, she wouldn't just leave, not without telling us or leaving some kind of a note.
It's all right.
Steady.
I'm worried that something has happened to Catherine. This is not like her.
Listen, some terrible things have happened, but so far no one's been truly hurt. I'm sure she's fine. It will take 25 minutes to get to town, hopefully less back, depending on if I can secure a carriage. But under no circumstances do I want you to go into the house.
Finally, we're in agreement on something. She'll be fine with me.
I know. Try to rest. Stay close. Do not go into the house. I'll be back soon.
John? I've been so foolish and so selfish for such a long time.
No. No.
I haven't been seeing clearly. I hadn't been seeing you. Why have you stayed with me?
Don't you know?
Because you're a good husband.
Because I love you. Are you here to stop me?
Charlotte? Charlotte? We've been trying to tell you to leave.
You are not a phantom.
Ik ben een man. Maar ik ben vergiftigd. Deze ziekte strandt al zo lang.
Where is my wife?
Door mijn aderen.
Where is my wife?
Ik ben moe. Ik ben moe. Ik ben Eckhart van Wakefield.
Wakefield. How? Where is my wife?
How strong is your love, Dr. Whalen? How strong...
What have you done with my wife?
Is your love...
What have you done with my wife? I want you...
She is dead. Her heart will never beat again. But the disease will keep her body animate. We have lived with this thing just short of 3 centuries. You're going to have to make a choice now, John. You can leave her here, abandoned, unaided, trapped in that flesh indefinitely, able to think, to dream, to hear, but helpless. And you very soon will die. Or you can bring to this house those from whom she can feed. And in turn, she can feed you. You will be bound together in the cycle until she finds another to give it to. I tell you these things because I made a promise to do so, if it came to that. Time is short now, John, so listen carefully. She will be useless during the day, and you will not. But she will be able to perform the most miraculous things during the night, and you will not. The rest, you will come to know. Oh, one other thing. For reasons I do not understand, she will be able to affect and manipulate the wills of some animals. Rodents and wolves appear to be the most susceptible. You can use the other grave now, John, for the sister. In homes, we were all born. In homes, we all die. Or hope to die.
Sarah was ever here. Grief was our ghost. And all the victims who hover over this house tried to warn us. Charlotte had written, "The wallpaper pattern does move. And no wonder. The woman behind shakes it."
It looks great. Have you shown it to anyone else?
Not yet.
All right, so what's the deal? How can you afford to rent it so cheap?
Oh, well, the owners paid for the house long ago. What do you do for work?
I'm in construction. My wife's the one with the exciting job.
I'm a writer. Social commentary. It's nothing.
My wife is a writer.
Really? What's her name?
Charlotte. But she's been using pen names forever now.
And I suppose we couldn't take down the wallpaper?
Oh, Travis. This could be the nursery. It's perfect.
Colleen, it's a little out of the way, don't you think? We're expecting a daughter.
Congratulations.